And success. So, the user agent brought to the mod on his clear view and realized that all of the RF modules, also the one of the clear view, use the same RF chip. So the SPI commands to change the channels are the same. Now, I had an old RealACC diversity module. It's pretty much the same as the LaForge and the TrueD from Furious FPV. You can get it on Banggood for I think $50, something like that. And I removed the RX 5808 modules from it because I needed them for another project. Now, what I did here was I cut the SPI traces here between the Clearview main board and the Clearview RF modules and connected them to the SPI outs from the RealACC module. Also, there is an RSSI pin from the RealACC modules that goes to this pin here at the side of the modules. This is just a 5-volt regulator because the Clearview works on 3.3 and this one needs 5 volts. Now, I have this wallet here and we are set at 5860 now. That is the frequency that my copter is transmitting right now. So if I change channels, Clearview changes channels. If I go far enough, we are losing Clearview lock. Okay. When I go back to FatShark 7. It will take a few seconds, but then the Clearview lock will come back. Yeah, we're back. The frequency that it shows here is not correct because it doesn't know the frequency anymore, but it doesn't need to because we will do this with the OLED right now or from now on. Now, there are also features like the band scanner, which also works because we have the RSSI. During the band scan, the image goes black and gets some errors, it seems like. But yeah, it's okay. Now, if I go back to manual mode and to and we're back. Okay. Now, next step will be to remove this weird button and put three push buttons because I really don't like this one. And put all this stuff, the Clearview back in my drainage where it was. And the OLED and the three push buttons will go here. So I will 3D print a new backplate. And yeah. Hope you like it.